As the new dominant COVID variant called BQ.1 emerges, scientists are looking beyond traditional methods to track its spread. The newest tool in their arsenal, wastewater. Special correspondent Kat Wise traveled to California, one of the first states to test wastewater for COVID.
Every day, more than 100 million gallons of wastewater flows into this treatment facility in Santa Clara County, California. It's the largest in the San Francisco Bay Area, serving more than 1 million residents in Silicon Valley. The sewage spewing out from these tanks is something most people want to avoid.
Extract the RNA from the wastewater.
But Stanford University environmental and civil engineering professor Alexandria Baim sees a public health gold mine.
Can we look at all the samples together?
In March of 2020, just weeks after one of the first coronavirus cases in the country was confirmed here in Santa Clara County, Baim and her colleagues began testing wastewater samples.
We found that we could detect SARS-CoV-2 RNA in wastewater, and then we found that we could measure its concentration and see how it could change over time and how that matched with data from reported cases. I was running with my cell phone and I got in the first set of results, and I could see right then and there that the changes in concentration were similar to what was happening with the cases, and I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this is gonna work.
Using wastewater to monitor viruses is not new. For decades, scientists around the world have used wastewater to track polio outbreaks. But it had never been used to track a respiratory disease. People infected with COVID can shed the virus in their waste days or weeks before they may have symptoms, which Baim says can provide an early warning for public health officials.
Wastewater surveillance is it could be like a complete revolution in the way that we track infectious disease in communities. And the uptake of this like technology is really unprecedented. We've gone from zero to 100 in like 2 years.
In November of 2020, she and her colleagues launched a program to track COVID at 8 Northern California treatment plants. It has now expanded to 70 sites. And is part of the CDC's own wastewater surveillance system, which generates data from more than 1,000 sites.
Make sure everything runs smoothly.
At the San Jose Santa Clara wastewater facility, operator Justin Sabla took us to an underground area where he and his colleagues take samples of semi-solid waste, known as sludge, every 4 hours.
Well, we usually try to get about 250 milliliters of sample, roughly.
The samples are sent to a lab where they're tested not only for COVID, but also influenza, respiratory syncytial virus, or RSV, and monkeypox, known as mpox in California. The results are sent to public health officials around the country, including Dr. Sarah Cody, the head of Santa Clara's public health department.
What you really need to do is look at where are we now in the wastewater.
Cody now has more than 2 years worth of data showing how closely COVID cases in her county correlated with virus levels in the wastewater. Then, this summer, Cody says fewer people were tested at clinics and hospitals, but wastewater concentrations stayed high.
When I see this, I see why over time we've had growing confidence that the wastewater is the truth. And now we can certainly see that the wastewater levels are still elevated, and we trust that. We know the wastewater doesn't lie.
Cody says she now regularly relies on Stanford's data to make public health decisions, like recommending that residents continue to mask indoors in public places. One downside to wastewater monitoring, however, is time and money. But officials here say it only costs about $100 every time a disease is tested. That can vary elsewhere depending on location and population being tested.
If you take one sample of wastewater, you can get information about, in San Jose, 1.5 million people, or even at a small plant, 10,000 people. Multiply the cost of the wastewater test by the number of people. So in that sense, wastewater is not cost prohibitive. It is actually really cheap and economical.
Still, there are concerns some communities will be left out as wastewater testing expands. The rural town of Esparto, where nearly 50% of residents are Latino, is now part of a program sampling treatment facilities across California's Central Valley. Like many communities in the area, it was hit hard by the pandemic, but didn't have access to wastewater testing early on to track the spread.
This is something that becomes really important if we have wastewater monitoring data to make that available for the public.
Heather Bischel is a civil and environmental engineer at UC Davis and one of the lead researchers in the program. She says it's important wastewater testing captures data for underserved communities.
What we wanted to do was help fill that data gap and really try to focus on increasing health equity by increasing access to data across all of our communities, and especially rural areas, agricultural areas, and disadvantaged communities.
Downgrade to our medium levels.
Dr. Amy Sisson is Yolo County's public health officer. She says wastewater surveillance can be especially helpful for tracking disease in communities that may have limited access to testing.
Now we have this additional tool in our toolbox to be able to look at what's happening in an entire community instead of relying on the people who are able to get tested. But I can't make any individual level decisions. I can't say, you know, it was this household, that household. And so that's the piece that we can't tease out in terms of who needs to get treatment, who needs to isolate.
Back at Stanford, BAME hopes wastewater testing will continue to expand around the country.
I know in California that wastewater surveillance is probably here to stay. And I hope that there is enough funding through the state government and through the federal government to really make this part of our infrastructure for health monitoring in the United States.
Infrastructure, she says, that could one day help prepare us for the next pandemic. For PBS News Weekend, I'm Kat Wise in San Jose, California.